제국주의자들이 날로 악랄해지는 핵전쟁 위협에 대처한 우리 첫 수소탄 시험과 각이한 공격수단들의 시험 발사, 핵탄도 폭발 시험이 성공적으로 진행되었으며 첨단 무장장비 연구 개발 사업이 활발해지고 대륙간 탄도로켓 시험 발사 준비 사업이 마감 단계에 이른 것을 비롯하여 국방력 강화를 위한 경의적인 사변들이 다계단으로 연발적으로 이룩됨으로써 조국과 민족의 운명을 수호하고 사회주의 강국 건설 위협을 승리적으로 전진시켜 나갈 수 있는 위력한 군사적 담보가 마련되었습니다. 남수선을 타고 앉아 아시아 태평양 지배 전략을 실현하려는 미국을 비롯한 외세의 침략과 간섭 책동을 끝장내며 진정한 민족의 주족도 가려보지 못하고 동족 대결에서 살 길을 찾는 박근혜와 같은 반통일 4대 매국 세력이 준동을 분쇄하기 위한 전민족적 투쟁을 힘있게 벌려야 합니다. 미국은 조선민족의 통일 의지를 똑바로 보고 남조선의 반통일 세력을 동족 대결과 전쟁으로 부추기는 민족이간 술책에 더 이상 매달리지 말아야 하며 시대착오적인 대조선 적대시 정책을 철회할 용단을 내려야 합니다.
北朝鮮の 미사일 발사와 단지대 용인できません. 私と 트럼프 대통령は 日米 동맹을 さらに 긴밀化し そして 強化していくことで 完全に一致をいたしました.
I just want everybody to understand and fully know that the United States of America stands behind Japan, its great ally, 100%.
North Korea has shown itself to be an irresponsible nation in every way, and I'm sure they're testing President Trump. I was glad he issued the statement with the Prime Minister of Japan. But he also ought to do it quickly with South Korea. South Korea is probably more susceptible to North Korea's virulence than any other country. And there was some doubt cast on the relationship in the campaign by the then candidate Trump. So do the same thing with South Korea that he did with Japan and do it quickly. The real answer to curtailing North Korea is China. Like on so many other areas, China has been woefully inadequate and they could squeeze North Korea economically. 90% of the imports and exports go through China. And I think we have to tell the Chinese that they have to put the wood to North Korea in a much more serious way than they've done so far.
우리 공화국 정부는 우리 공화국을 압살하는 적들의 체적 대응이 계속되는 한 핵무력을 중출하는 자적 국방력과 선지 공격 능력을 계속 강화하는 것이라는 원칙적 입장을 명백히 밝혔습니다. 우리 인민은 반드시 우리 힘으로 우리 국가 세계 평화 안전을 수호하는 데 적극 기여할 것입니다.
우리는 실생활을 통하여 선군의 힘이 우리 조국을 지키고 민족을 지키는 힘이라는 것을 알게 되었습니다. 우리는 앞으로도 군우가 뭐라고 하든 자주의 길, 선군의 길로 나갈 것입니다.
North Korea uses its annual celebration of the birth of the country's founder, Kim Il-sung, to flaunt its missile arsenal and show off its armed forces to external enemies. Columns of goose-stepping soldiers marched in formation as the country's current leader, Kim Jong-un, waved from a balcony. There were several notable missile systems on display at Saturday's military parade. The Pukuksong-1 was displayed for the first time. It's an intermediate-range submarine-launched ballistic missile that was successfully tested in August 2016. The Pukuksong-2 is the land-based variant of the Pukuksong-1. It was successfully tested in February 2017 and also was displayed for the first time on Saturday. The Scud-ER is designed to reach American military bases in South Korea and Japan. Four of these were launched in March, with some splashing down in the waters of Japan's exclusive economic zone. The KN-08 was first unveiled in 2012 and is thought to have been designed as the country's first intercontinental ballistic missile. Experts say it has the potential to reach the west coast of the United States, but it has never been tested. One of the big surprises of the parade was the unveiling of potential new intercontinental ballistic missiles. Some experts say this canister could contain a variant of the KN-14, which was disclosed for the first time in 2015. And this appears to be yet another potential intercontinental ballistic missile. These launch tubes could also be empty decoys or mock-ups of systems still under development. On Sunday, a day after the parade, North Korea launched a ballistic missile, but it appeared to fail just after liftoff. In any case, North Korea was clearly trying to demonstrate that its military reach was expanding at a time of heightened tensions with the United States.
Let me be very clear. The policy of strategic patience has ended. We're exploring a new range of diplomatic, security, and economic measures. All options are on the table if they elevate the threat of their weapons program to a level that we believe requires action. That option is on the table. While we acknowledge China's opposition, its economic retaliation against South Korea is inappropriate and troubling.
想强调一点，就是，我们坚决反对美韩在韩国部署萨德反导系统，也将坚决采取必要的措施来维护自身的安全利益。由此产生的一些后果由美韩来承担。我们再次强烈敦促有关的方面停止部署进程，不要在错误的道路上越走越远。
Hi, my name's Kim Han-sol, from North Korea.
This is Kim Han-sol. He's a young college-educated 20-something, well-traveled and fluent in English.
I got to meet friends from all over the world.
In short, he's the antithesis of what most people in the West think of when they think of North Korea. There's something else unusual about him. His uncle is North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, a dictator who runs his country as a police state and a personality cult. Experts on North Korea suspect that it was Kim Jong-un who was behind the killing of Han Sol's father in an airport in Malaysia on February the 13th. So who is Kim Han-sol? He was born in Pyongyang, though he has lived abroad for most of his life. In the eyes of some observers, he seems to be a symbol of sorts for what North Korea could be, cosmopolitan and open to the outside world.
I like the food, the people are very nice here.
And then another possibility presents itself. Could this young man someday become the next leader of a more moderate, more engaged nation? Here's where Han Sol fits on the family tree. Kim Han Sol is the youngest male of the Kim family bloodline. He is the son of Kim Jong-nam, the recently assassinated half-brother of the current ruler, Kim Jong-un. Their father was Kim Jong-il, and his father was Kim Il-sung, the founder of North Korea. Han Sol has commented on politics in the past. He did the unthinkable by North Korean standards and called his uncle a dictator.
I really never met them in real life, so I really don't know how it became, how he became a dictator.
And in that same 2012 interview with a Finnish television station, he also expressed his wish to improve relations between North and South Korea.
I've always dreamed that one day I will go back and make things better and make it easier for the people there.
But many experts say the chances of Han Sol one day leading North Korea are slim. North Korea expert Bruce Cummings says Han Sol's genealogy would make him high royalty in his nation, but he's much too young. And most people in North Korea might not even know he exists. According to Stephen Norper, information in the country is so tightly controlled that any reference to Han Sol would likely never appear in the state-controlled press. It also seems highly unlikely current leader Kim Jong-un would pick a successor who has been so openly critical of him. Among North Korean elites, any defectors are considered enemies of the regime. Andrei Lankov says Hansol would be considered an apostate. And his bloodline might even pose a threat to his life, like it did to his father, who was killed although he kept a low profile and was not known to have any political aspiration. Purges and targeted killings have allowed Kim Jong-un to consolidate his power. But even if he were somehow toppled, experts say it would likely mean the end of the Kim clan's dominance, not the rise of Han Sol.